Don't forget to check out my Patreon, where we have exclusive content such as Camp Zero Base One, 17's Nana Tour, 17 in the Soup, Finding Stray Kids, Blackpink House, EXO's Ladder, EXO Showtime, A-Pink Showtime, and tons of other content, including extra variety shows, K-dramas, animes, and movies. Hey guys, Angie here, and today we have the boys' Nectar music video. It's kind of a mini or solo album. It's more of a solo with like just two other tracks, Hurt Me Less and Dear. We're doing this special clip for Dear, so I actually missed that one, so it's a new song for me. But let's hop into the video. We have a whole movie here. Dun. Dun, 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 dun. Do they have to? Is this their year of re-signing? I thought about that. Oh wait, that's cool. Oh yeah, he looks so good. That's the thing you hide under. I love this part. Why is this making me want to cry? I feel like I can see them renewing. Part of me thinks I wouldn't blame them if they didn't. Also, that's from their debut album, right? The cloud painting background. Is that a reference to that? Such a beautiful. Is this cool thing? Because wasn't it a school concept? Their debut? I can't remember if that was their debut. I mean, but, boy. Damn, why does this make me cry? Guys. The song in the music video is kind of making me a little. All leader. There's something very emotional about this. That's also what's making me like. I like they don't care, they clearly don't care about streaming. They did this with Lips. Oh my god, freaking song from last year, Lips. Where is it? Yeah. Lip gloss. That was a 6-minute video. My fans are like, dang, we can't stream. We can, but it's just, you know, it's harder. And I kind of respect their, like, whatever. Is this like a proper comeback? I think it is. It's part of the fantasy series. But like, are they going to do promotions and stuff? I really want to play with that, like, powder stuff. That was so cute. That's what I'm saying, like, it doesn't... Okay, so we all agree. Yeah, I don't, why did this make me so, why did this make me feel so, yeah, this makes me want to cry away in a good way. I don't know why, something about it kind of, I look silly, I know. Something about just made me kind of feel a weird inside. Oh wait, let me add this real quick. Wait, where'd it go? No, I lost it. I just saw it. I think they did something. Whatever. I thought I saw something with them. This is weakening emotion here. Kinda reminds me of FNL by 17. Why they got me? Oh, they're getting me with this album. You mean the feeling, this pain that you make me believe it. Oh, I don't know. I think this album. Well, that's only three songs, cause. Oh, Sunu, come back. This is, oh my god. Let me make sure to add these to the playlist, because they got me in pain. Oh, it's kind of like Broken Melodies by NCT Dream, Hello Future, like that feeling it's giving me. And I Know I Love You by TXT, like that energy of just, it's making me all want to cry. Maybe I'm just in my feels. Maybe I'm just in my feels. Leave me alone. Don't judge me. These songs make me emotional. I was hoping this part would come back. Show me the meaning. That was beautiful. I'm assuming, oh, did they debut? I think this is their debut day, right? Because they debuted December 2017. Let me see if have they already done their contract? Because wouldn't it be, it'd be this year, because 7 years. So they did it at the concert. While listening to Boys. Very concerty. I mean, Christmassy. Okay, so yeah, A-Pink left, Victon left, Weekly got fucked over. So this means the boys will likely leave, or the company's gonna be so desperate that they're gonna do everything they can to make sure they stay. So either they're gonna get a great contract, or the boys are leaving. I don't see the boys staying unless they have a great contract, because the company's gonna have to fold for them. They have no other hope. They only have Weekly and ATBO. You look so pretty. I don't blame them if they don't stay though, because they were treated so shit and so many injuries, and they did get some mental health leaves, which is good at least, but I don't know. The company doesn't treat them very well. Just because they let them go on hiatuses doesn't really mean much, because they still were treated badly enough to cause that. This was a cute song. I mean, pretty simple, cute little ballad. It says encore version. I'm wondering how different. Oops. It sounds the same, so I don't know what that means. I guess it just means that's from the encore. Cute. I mean, definitely Chart Me Less is my favorite, and Nectar is beautiful. Like, this is probably. So for me, the boys' discography is pretty solid. Like, there's songs I don't add really, but like overall, I like from their debut to now. Like, there's no album I dislike. Like, I like a lot of their songs from debut. Like, I'm not someone who only likes their newer stuff. Because I joined, Hwa was I think on hiatus and then left. Like, before I got to know the members, but I liked Hwa right away. Like, Hwa was my, if you don't know who Hwa is, then I'm old. I think most of you are fans from when that era, though. Like, I'm pretty sure most of you know who Hwa is. Hyunjin. Hyunjun. But he was gonna be in my vibes, but I never really got to know him during the group. It was more like everything I liked from before. Which, by the way, we never finished the Brooklyn. We had to watch that because he's in that. I was holding off for him. But like Thrill Ride is like my favorite song, title track wise, I think. For the most part, at least. I think Thrill Ride is my favorite. I love I let neither know. Bump in Love is one of my favorite songs from them. But like, yeah. So I joined, like, I guess it would be, was it Tattoo? I think it was Tattoo, because I think it was before Reveal. So it must have been Tattoo. But I think Reveal, that album, is what made me really like them. But then I went back and I liked so many of their older songs. So yeah, I mean, there's no songs I really dislike from the group. Like, it's either like I'm just like, eh. Like, was it DDD? I like DDD. I don't know. But yeah, I kind of want to get back into the variety stuff. What was it called? I forgot the show's name. I paused it because I was like, oh, I don't want to waste all my fall energy. Like, all my fall, like, content. I wanted him in it. Oh, it's, Come On, the Boys, that show. That's the show. Yeah, we did GOTSING, Summer, our. That's the season I became a fan of. But yeah, they have one in New York. But I don't know if people would care to really watch it with me anymore because it's kind of old. But I mean, there's only a couple episodes. So hey, we may get back into that because looks interesting. There's only four episodes. So yeah, I mean, hey, let's do that. Maybe we'll return to that. But anyways, let me know your favorites. Let me know if you also kind of got emotional during it, because I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, why did I get so emotional? I don't know. How do the fandom. I feel like some people may think it's a boring comeback, though. Okay, it has a positive response. That's great. Yeah, I feel like it kind of just, there's something nostalgic about it in the sense of their older music, but also just like you can kind of relate to it, right? And then there's like, it kind of tricks you because the title doesn't sound like it's gonna be a cute song. Like, it sounds like it's gonna be a sexy song, but nope, they tricked you. But anyways, let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you guys in maybe Come On, the Boys. So, see you guys then. Bye.